So the main question is, what do you think happens after we die?
And then, what do I think?
And then I'll be like, I wonder what your story is.
What I believe what happens is that we all have choices in life, and it's up to us. I believe there is a heaven and there's a hell.
Yeah.
If there's a heaven, there's a hell. A lot of people are like, oh, there's a heaven and no hell.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Well, anyway.
It's just like
I believe we have choices.
Uh-huh.
And what we choose to do on earth, God wants us to love him, praise him, and be happy, and do what we please.
Yeah.
But not sin.
Yeah.
Obviously, but if we do, we have to love God and ask Jesus Christ for our...
Yeah.
Well, no, okay, go, sorry. But
yeah.
Anyway, so,
do you...
I believe we either go to heaven or hell.
Do you have a church background, or, like, how did you find out these things?
My grandmother is very, very, very... I wouldn't say religious, but she loves God with all her heart.
Uh-huh.
And she raised us very well from the book. And
so, like, read to you from the Bible, or?
Yeah, and not only that, she just read from her. Our family have gifts. Everyone's born with gifts. It's a matter of how we use our gifts.
Yeah.
Everyone's there for a reason.
Yeah.
Like, things just happen. Like, how do we just come across?
Exactly. Yeah.
And I've been actually having many questions I've been asking God, praying about. And for that question, what do you think will happen? Are you Catholic or are you Christian?
I'm Protestant, which is Christian.
Protestant.
Yeah. I mean, Catholic supposedly is Christian too, but I go to New Life, if you're familiar with New Life Church.
No, I'm not familiar.
Yeah. Do you have any church involvement?
Not too much. I like to praise God at home because I don't like to feel comfortable at churches, because I feel a lot of times when I went to church they were judgy-ish.
Yeah.
And I feel more comfortable praising God in my own bubble.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And there's nothing wrong with that.
Right.
I don't think so. Because you don't have to be in a church to talk to God.
Right.
You know?
As a matter of fact, I mean, and I hope, because we talk to God more than once a week.
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly.
So.
So it all depends on our choices. Is what I believe on what happens when we die. To answer your question, it's choices.
Yeah. And you talked about sin, and you talked about Jesus, right? And you do believe in hell. So in other words, some people are going to heaven and some will be going to hell.
The devil has his spawns as God has his spawns.
Yeah.
God has his people who he has worked for him, and the devil has his people who work for him, are just down, has no soul.
Yeah.
Cold-hearted.
Yeah.
And me, I don't want to be one of those people.
No.
I don't want to rot in hell for all eternity and burn. So I'd rather be happy, walk streets of gold with God, and sleep on bears.
Sleep on what?
Bears.
Bears?
Yeah. In heaven, it's going to be beautiful.
Yeah.
It's going to be beautiful.
Cool. So how can you be sure you're not, you are headed for heaven, you know?
Because we're all God's children. And it's up to us to go forth with it, and I've been trying, and keep my faith and my firm belief in God and keep on going.
Yeah, yeah.
And just try to keep a pure heart.
One of the things you were saying, though, is like, okay, the devil has his own, right?
Yes.
And God has his own. So for all God's children, you see what I'm saying? Like,
yes.
Who would be the devil's
son? Because the devil visits heaven every day. The devil goes and sees God all the time. He's welcome there, but he can't stay there. But they talk. He says, "Oh, who am I gonna take?" They literally do other souls. God looks down on us like we're ants.
Uh-huh.
We are. We literally are.
Oh yeah, compared to God, yeah.
And it's beautiful. And it's all a mystery, and it's all we'll find out when God tells us and shows us. Me, God, I see. God shows me things in my dreams, which is amazing. It's a beautiful gift.
Uh-huh.
And
that would be your gift then?
Yeah, I dream.
Joseph the dreamer. It's like
Joseph, which is one of the odds, right? But my family's very spiritual. I was haunted as a kid a lot from demons, ghosts and demons.
Uh-huh.
I've seen a lot of them. I live in the projects right there.
Yeah.
So it's very, very infested in demons.
Yeah.
And me and my grandmother, who actually taught me, and my mother, wanted to do the Jericho walk across the projects to fight, I guess, demons.
Okay.
In Jesus' name, the Holy Spirit. So, I mean, we're going to be fasting within a week. For 2 to 3 weeks, we're going to fast.
Really? Does that mean you go the whole time without food then, or?
No, if you can fast in any other ways you feel what God shows you. Me personally, which would be intimately with some my girlfriend, my beloved.
Oh,
my life.
Fasting from the
yes.
relations.
Yes.
I see.
Because therefore it's a sin because I'm not married to the one I'm with.
Yeah.
She's only my girlfriend. I've been with for 7 years.
Yeah.
So it's still a sin because we're not married.
I see.
So yeah. That's another thing I'm still sinning. We are going to sin until we almost die. Well, until the day we die, we're going to sin.
Yeah.
But that's why Jesus Christ is there and God loves us. And we just got to keep a firm faith, belief.
Yeah.
Keep on looking forward.
Now, would you say you repent of that sin?
I can't yet because I'm still sinning.
Right.
So I would have to either stop or get married.
Does it... How does that affect your relationship with God? That you're living in this a lifestyle where you're not repenting from your sin?
It's you know a very I mean? Good question that has ups and downs, which says I'm strong but then I'm weak because that's how the devil creeps in and demons torment me and takes me off the track of what I'm supposed to be with God.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. And I have to be stronger. I have to be more firm to keep on going.
Yeah.
But everyone has this downfall. I'm still young. I want to learn and be wise and grow older and stop. But
yeah.
Soon to be.
Now, let me ask you this. So you believe Jesus is the one who forgives us our sins, right?
Jesus, God, and the Holy Spirit, yes.
Yeah.
Trilogy.
So what's the difference between someone who ends up in hell because they're sinful, right? And someone who ends up in heaven because they're sinful, even though they're sinful.
Well,
you know what I'm saying?
Because that's God's choice. That's not up to us to really judge or think about. But to think of that, I would say, for one to not actually fully mean it, because a rapist, a killer, a murderer, a thief, is still enter the gates of heaven if they actually fully understand and repent from their sins and have that feeling that the holiness in us, the whole our conscience, our holiness inside of us, to feel that thrill, that peace. And that's how I don't know, because I don't know, because you know when you do something bad, it either bothers you or it don't.
Yeah.
If it don't, you're just cold-hearted, I guess. You know.
Would you say you're cold-hearted because you're not repenting?
No. For example, if a thief comes into your house, are you just going to let them come in?
No.
Exactly.
You're going to fight it. Fight him.
And is God going to judge you for fighting the thief entering your home? Oh, you killed the man.
Yeah.
No, you killed the man because you're protecting your home, your life, your son's life, your daughter's life, your wife's life.
Yeah.
So it all depends on choices and how the... act of the time is, I don't know, how it goes on.
So
it all depends.
It sounds like, would you say you're a good person?
I like to say I'm an okay person. I try to make choices, the right decisions. But I do make the wrong decisions, as we all do.
Yeah.
But I learn and I try to observe and realize the wrong things I do, that even what I don't realize.
Yeah.
I realize how much I bother people without me never realizing, like, oh wow, I never seen that about myself.
Yeah.
And the only thing you can do is just fix that.
Yeah.
And that, because I would treat somebody a certain way, but not without me realizing it from my own emotions, from nothing, which could, I mean, it's not coming to my head at the moment, but anything.
Yeah.
But it doesn't make me a bad person, just me not communicating the proper way.
I see.
So.
Because the reason I'm asking that is because sometimes it's easy to focus on one sin in our life, and then we come up with all sorts of reasons why we do it, right? And then maybe we forget about others, right?
Yeah.
So I'm going to give you a little good person test, okay? How many lies do you think you've told in your life?
In my life?
Yeah.
Oh, it's many.
Many? Okay. Many. What would you be called if you told lies?
Lies as in, there's everybody lies. It's just,
right.
It's like saying, oh, do I look pretty? Yeah, you look pretty. That could be a lie, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
it could be like something like that.
Yeah.
Yes, it bothers me, but we just, certain people can't be fully truthful. Be like,
okay, it might be true that everyone has the same name. So if you murder, you're a murderer. If you lie, you're a
liar.
Liar. Okay.
Yeah.
So I'm not trying to judge or anything. I'm just trying to get you to look at this logically. So you have told lies, you'd be a liar. Have you ever taken anything that didn't belong to you?
When I was younger, yes.
Okay, what would you be called then?
I was a thief. A thief.
Okay, and it's not going away because you've done it, and you probably knew it was wrong when you did it, right?
When I was younger, yeah.
Yeah. Have you ever taken God's name in vain?
Yes.
Like used God's name disrespectfully? Yeah. Okay.
Like, oh my, yes. Yeah.
So you'd be a blasphemer? I mean, it's like disrespecting God.
Yeah, it's very, yeah, and it bothers me when I say that. I'm like, oh God, please forgive me, I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's good that you do say that you're sorry, you're aware of it.
Because it's very, it's a powerful word.
And the Bible says you shall not commit murder, but then it goes on, Jesus said you shall not commit murder, but then he said, if you have anger in your heart and you call your brother a fool, you're in danger of the fire of hell. So would you be guilty, not just of, you know, like, hopefully you haven't murdered anyone, but have you hurt anyone with your words? Said things that would be disrespectful or hurting others.
Yes.
Okay. So it's kind of like committing murder in your heart.
Yeah, it's like throwing swords inside. Swords.
And then you've already, you know, admitted you're committing adultery, but even if you look with lust, because a couple of verses later, Jesus was saying, you know, if you look with lust, you're committing adultery in your heart. So it might be going on more than you even realize.
Exactly.
See what I'm saying?
No, it's very true.
So if you died today, you'd stand before God and you'd be a liar and a thief and a murderer at heart, an adulterer and a...
All these things that I had to think about for God to forgive me. Because we all have judgment day. We all die twice, literally.
Yeah.
We die, we go to heaven, we go to judgment. And that from the judgment is where we go to heaven or hell.
Yeah. And so you'd be guilty, right?
Depending on...
Huh?
Depending.
Depending on what?
Depending.
Like,
but I know I'm not gonna die today. You know, so a guy told me when I was gonna die.
Oh really? I don't think I'd want to know that.
It's
for myself.
It's frightening for people.
Yeah.
It's very frightening.
Yeah.
But I don't want to live long, and I don't want to live short. 85 is my max.
Uh huh.
And I'm satisfied with that.
So you're convinced that you're going to live a long life.
Long life.
But it's not possible that you could die anytime?
Oh, it's very possible.
Yeah.
I've asked God to take me.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
The reason I'm asking this is because if you stand before God, if it's just based on your actions, right, on all of our actions, we're going to be, I'm going to be guilty. You'd be guilty too, right, of having broken God's laws. So it's not just the one.
Do you follow the Ten Commandments or Jesus Christ?
Well, the Bible talks about using the Ten Commandments to show us our need for Christ. See what I'm saying?
Exactly.
And so the Ten Commandments is what, it's kind of like it makes us aware of all the things that we're doing wrong so that we can say, you know what, I could never live up to that, and I've already broken them, you know.
That's what Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying, but a lot of people believe in that, but believe in believe in the Ten Commandments and Jesus Christ, but follow the Ten Commandments, and they're going to get judged by the Ten Commandments. That's what God says.
Yeah.
I don't want to be judged by the Ten Commandments.
That's good. That's wise.
I've broken 8 of them.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like, I never prayed to a statue or any other guy before God because he's a jealous guy, and I felt that's one thing because, I don't know, I don't like to pray to a statue. It's just rock. It's just stone.
Yeah.
Which, you know what I mean? That's what I believe.
Yeah.
It's like...
Well, I want to encourage you to repent of the sins, that you know of, you know?
It's very, very good.
The thing is, if you have put your faith in Jesus, right? It sounds like you have. I don't know your heart, but... So if you're trusting in Jesus and not in following the Ten Commandments for your relationship with God, then the Bible says you would be a child of God, right?
Yes.
Now, the other part of it, though, is a father disciplines his children, right?
Yeah.
So even though God may forgive you as far as eternity is concerned, he still may discipline you here on earth, right? So the one thing, I mean, I'm not, I don't want to wish anything bad on you, but I'm just saying, you're opening yourself up to the discipline of God. If he has to get your attention, he may do who knows what, you know?
I know.
He wants a right relationship with you. That's what righteousness is, you know, a right relationship with God. And repentance is the way to that, you know? What keeps you from getting married if you guys have been together for so long?
It's complicated.
Yeah.
I love her a lot. Since I was a young age, I always wanted children.
Uh-huh.
And with her, it's very, very, like...
She doesn't want any children.
She wants to, but she might not be able to. So.
I see. Yeah.
So it's very hard, that's complicated. Hard. And something that I've seen, that God showed me, answered my prayers, and that I ran from.
Yeah.
I kept on sinning for running, just running from it. Yeah.
Well... There's lots of instances in the Bible where God answers people's prayers like that.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Maybe if you start, you know, like maybe he'll bless you in that way. You know?
Yeah.
I'm not sure what it would take to repent, you know. It's been going on for a long time, so it's, you know, right?
How old are you again?
Hmm?
How old are you?
Old? 56.
56? I'm 18.
18? Oh, so you've been going out with her... Since you were very young, I see. I thought you were older than
that. No, I'm 18 years old.
Yeah.
A young guy.
Yeah. Well, that's hard. It's you're at an age where, you know, physical temptation is huge, you know?
Yeah.
A
lot of people think I'm old, too.
You look older.
I'm
I guess
older
the facial hair or something.
Not only that, it's just spiritually. I love God, and God gave me a good heart.
Yeah. Are you financially
stable? I'm working a little bit right now. I'm working. I work at Northside.
Yeah.
I work at a restaurant.
Okay.
I'm okay.
Well, I just want to encourage you, you know, the Bible says repent and believe, and that repentance part is so important.
Thank you.
For our relationship with God.
I appreciate that very much.
And I'm going to be praying for you.
Thank you.
And like I say, I go to... The other thing about church is, yeah, you can worship God at home. But you're missing out. You have brothers and sisters?
I understand. I have two brothers.
I mean, I don't know what your relationship with them would be like, but it's like God is our father.
Others
and he wants...
Chain.
Yeah.
There's more... I understand.
He wants his children to have good relationships with each other, too.
That's true. Respect that neighbor.
So, yeah.
It's very true. My grandmother and family taught us very well.
Yeah.
But it's just...
Does she go to church?
My grandma, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, she used to live here. She moved. We used to go to the church right there.
Central Assembly?
Yeah, we used to go there.
Pastor John?
Yeah, we stopped going there. Pastor John knows who our family is.
Yeah. Yeah. That's cool. But, I appreciate your openness. Can I give you something to read that
I think
is interesting? So, this is a good, little book. So,
thank you, sir.
I love to get in these conversations and find out where people are at.
God bless you. God needs people like this. Keep on doing it.
And I got like a variety of things I give people. I kind of find out where they're at and give them what I think might be blessing.
Thank you.
A blessing for them. So
I'm gonna go check on my mother.
All right.
God bless you.
All right. Good to meet you, Joseph.